I've been talking about fairly popular things recently, and I think it's time to talk about something a little bit more obscure, something you might even consider lost. That's right, guys, we're gonna be talking about the critically acclaimed TV series, The Lost Room. I'm gonna be making this video a little different than my previous ones because this is a show that it's no longer in active development, but I do think people should go watch it. I think there's something special about the show, and the great part about it is the show's free on YouTube right now, so I'll post that in the link below so you guys can go see it. I'm thinking it's free on YouTube for everybody, but I only live in the US, so I don't know if it's free for anybody outside of the US. So sorry if you guys are from another continent. So for this video, we're gonna just go through a really quick spoiler-free summary of the show to see if it piques your interest, and if you guys do like it, you should go watch it. And then afterwards, we're gonna talk about spoilers of the show. So just a heads up right now, there will be spoilers here if you haven't watched it. So the story follows a man who discovers that there is a collection of regular, everyday objects that have anomalous properties. What kind of everyday objects, you may be asking? Like something like a wristwatch, but it doesn't tell time. It hard boils eggs. You put an egg on top of the watch and you got yourself a hard-boiled egg. The man, however, doesn't really care about these objects. He just wants to get his daughter back. The concept of this is super cool, and the world building is fantastic. And I don't think I can say much more without spoiling something in the show. So if you like that, please go watch it. I'll link it down below. If you didn't like it, I guess continue watching. Maybe you just like spoiling shit for yourself. Your choice. And with that out of the way, let's start talking about spoilers. This show is so fucking cool, and I'm definitely gonna talk about all the things that I like about it. But before we do that, let me talk about the things that I didn't like about it. Wait, don't tell me, dude, you won't believe what happened. Yes. To be fair, the acting is pretty standard for a 2006 sci-fi original.
I'll protect her, I promise. But Detective Joe, who's gonna protect you?
This is like pretty much right next to straight to DVD tier acting and a little bit above porno acting. Wait, don't tell me, dude, you won't believe what happened. Yes. This character is the blandest, most boring man I've ever seen in my entire life. He's got the personality of a piece of toast, and I'm supposed to believe he got laid twice? I hate him, but he's pivotal to the plot and I have to put up with him to enjoy the rest of it. Wait, don't tell me, dude, you won't believe what happened. Yes. I think the ending is decent by itself. I think it's a good close to Joe's story and it makes it so I never have to see him again. My problem with it is nothing ever really comes from it. The show was clearly left a little open so that they could revisit the story in the future, but it's 2023. And we've seen none of that. No webcomic, no prequel, no sequel. It's just been kind of silent for the past, what is that? 16, 17 years? I'm just happy some sci-fi intern found this in a corner of the warehouse and decided to release it on YouTube there. And I think that's enough of the bad. Let's get into the actual good, the meat and bones of this whole thing. The objects were so well done, and I think they very clearly inspired the SCP Foundation in some capacity. A watch that can boil eggs, a bus ticket that teleports you to a random city in New Mexico, and even a pen that just microwaves you. These are all just completely random items with completely random effects. And those are pretty cool by themselves, right? And then we're told that there's about 100 of these objects. We only really ever see maybe 20 in the show. So there's a whole horde of objects that we don't even know what they do. And then you take into account that those objects combined can have different effects. They explain in the show that the knife and the wristwatch together give you telepathy somehow. I think that in and of itself is just so incredibly cool, and I wish that would have been explored more with a sequel. I think it makes a ton of sense that not a lot of people know about these objects. because the people that do know about these objects are trying to keep it a secret from everybody else. And the people that do know about these objects also have their own interesting theories for why these objects exist and what they want to do with them. Some think that they should be destroyed, some want to use them for power, and some want to use them to get closer to God. I'm a complete sucker for sci-fi shows trying to exist in the same reality that we currently are in. And a lot of shows really mess that up because it's very difficult to get it right. But I think this show does a pretty damn good job. Having the Order of the Reunification be a religious group that believes getting the objects back together will be a way to speak to God? That's so outlandish, but that sounds like something that would really happen in our society if these objects were real. And it also kind of shows you why these objects are still around, why the government hasn't snatched them up, right? These are reality-altering objects, so everybody's worldviews are just challenged by the mere existence of these objects. And there is no consensus from anyone as to what to do with the objects. Sure, some people group together, but there's multiple groups. And as long as these people have differing ideas for what to do with these objects are always going to be around. There are very few times in my life that I found myself liking a side character way more than a main character. I've liked side characters before. That's kind of their thing. They have to be likable, otherwise people just don't care for them. But I think this is the first time I've seen a show where I just wish the main character didn't exist, and this show was revolving around one of the side characters. I think my favorite character is Wally because he's just a chaotic man. He's just carrying his little bus ticket around, and anytime anybody annoys him, he just sends them to New Mexico. Which is already punishment in and of itself, but he sends them to a random abandoned motel in New Mexico.
For your crimes against decency and politeness and common courtesy, yeah. I condemn you to hell!
And he's done this so many times that the people in Gallup think that that motel is haunted. I think Wally's awesome. Probably my second favorite character is the Weasel. Just such a weaselly little fuck that I can't hate him. It's literally his name. I can't hate him.
Huh. It doesn't work in the room.
And then there's the Sood, which is, I don't know what it is about him that just makes him so cool in my eyes. It's a guy that sells knowledge about objects, but doesn't actually try to get any objects himself because he knows how dangerous that is. I wish Joe had even an ounce of the character that these three characters had. I've been waiting for a day like this to come. Finally, my favorite part of the show is the explanation for the event. I think explanations can be extremely satisfying when done right. Knives Out is a good example of an explanation done right. The mystery is explained pretty well at the end, and you, as the audience, feel pretty satisfied with it, in my opinion. But sometimes explaining something isn't really worth it. For example, I was a big fan of The 100, which is a TV show in which the Earth is being recolonized decades after it was deemed uninhabitable. I'm not gonna spoil the show, but I hated their reasoning for why the Earth became uninhabitable because it was just so unoriginal. The Lost Room just says, fuck you to explanation. All of this happened for no good reason. Reality just teared a hole in itself and said, I'm feeling a little goofy. Now, some of you may find this explanation absolute bullshit and a cop-out for not having to explain what happened, but I think it just kind of fits. As far as we can see, there's nothing really magical about this world. There's no superheroes or anything. It just so happens that a tear in the fabric of reality happened inside of a random hotel. And I think that's just fitting. Do you know how many random events have occurred just for me to sit here and talk about this show? And then for you to be on the other side watching this video? And then for any of this technology to just exist and for us to actually even still be here? I thought it was super cool. You might disagree with me, but I think this is probably my favorite part of the show. Now look, I'm not crazy. I don't think the show is a 10 out of 10 top tier masterpiece. I think it would be a 7 out of 10 if you're being really generous. It's just, it's held back by a lot of things. Actors, their acting, the dialogue, the CGI, the budget. But I think this is the perfect kind of show that should get a sequel on one of the many streaming services we have out there right now. This show could be huge. It's pretty much an SCP type show that you can license. It doesn't have a Creative Commons license attached to it. And as the show's shown, there's about 100 objects or so. We only saw and heard of really like 20. There's like 80 more that we have to like actually see. And then there's the combination of the objects. I hate to see things like The Walking Dead get spin-off after spin-off, when shows like this got one chance and absolutely nothing else. And I hope that changes in the future. In short, I'd love for the show to get bigger. I'd love for the creators to see how much their show is loved. And I'd love for this to return in some capacity. Hell, maybe even as a book. I gotta stop talking about books. Either way, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope you guys find the time to watch the show if you haven't already. Peace.